Hi, my name is Antonis and I am an iconographer. For today, I will show you how I paint an angel's wing in iconography. Many of my viewers here have requested me to teach them how I paint an angel's wing. And I've decided to do this tutorial following the mainly the Cretan tradition, how an iconographer, a master iconographer of the Cretan tradition, used to paint an angel's wing. So welcome to this channel. I hope you find this tutorial helpful and interesting for your artistic growth. And if you haven't yet, please consider subscribing to this channel, as many tutorials are to be published. So, as you see, first I start by creating my drawing of the wing, of course, and then I transfer this drawing on my board. This board is prepared with rabbit skin glue gesso, and you can find the tutorial on how to create these boards if you are to paint with egg tempera or paint also with oil as your medium. You can also use that gesso as well. You can find this tutorial on the video list of this channel. So I transfer the drawing on my board, and here I have to say that many people send me their work, and it's really fantastic. I'm so happy to see your progress, and it's really nice. Most of all of your artworks are really nice, and to me it's always moving to see that people are interested in iconography, and that they like to paint in general. This is something that to me is very, I don't know, it has something very heartwarming. Anyway, the most my most common, let's say, advice that I would have to give is to pay more attention on the drawing part and try to improve your drawing skills, whether this concerns a secular painting or iconography. Many iconographers need to improve their drawing skills on the basic facial characteristics and the figure as well. To do that, I think it's important to learn very well how to use the grid method and apply this grid method to every kind of icon or painting you want to create. So anyway, I will not talk more of that. I have a video on my list about the grid method if you are interested to learn it better. It's a really great method to improve your drawing skills, but not, of course, the only one. So here what you see me doing is I have to say that the wings consist mainly from two proplasmid, two base colors. This is because the wings in the tradition of the Byzantine painting are, I suppose, are made in by two materials or two kind of feathers or something like that. There is the inside feather area, which is painted in blue generally, and the outer part of the wings, which we painted with this ochre brown color. So first, I paint the proplasmos, the base color of the inner part of the feathers, the blue part of the feathers. For this, I paint the proplasmo consisting from cobalt blue, some black, and I can break this with also some terra verde, some green. And I can also add just a tiny little bit of titanium white, just to keep the color a little bit more opaque. And for the proplasmo of my outer part of the wings, I use a very common base color in iconography. This is a yellow brownish proplasmos. It's used in many areas, like in some clothes of some parts of the clothes of Virgin Mary or the baby Jesus. It's a proplasmos that consists from yellow ochre, a little bit of cadmium yellow, and some black. I will. I can also add a little bit of Mars red, as a great subscriber told me it's called, or I call this iron oxide red, and I can also add a little bit of green. It depends on what specific hue you need to create. I've noticed that some iconographers paint this brownish proplasmo darker, some others paint this proplasmo lighter. Here I decided to go on the lighter side. And of course, here I will not add any gold leaves on the wing. I have another video on my list how to gild this kind of proplasmo. And so here I've decided just to show you better to paint this so-called chrysocotylia, the highlights of the wings, to paint it with actual color. This is something that is in the tradition of the Byzantine painting. The iconographers didn't only use gold to paint the wings. They often used the color as well. So I will start here. Actually, the inner part of the wings, this blue part of the wings, it's always painted with color. I don't recall having seen any icon where the inner part of the wings consists from gold leaves. So for this inner part, after painting the proplasmo, I will create a color that is much darker than the proplasmo, and I will draw the grapsimata, the darker feathers, let's say, or I will describe, I will go on the edge of these feathers and create the contours, let's say, of this area. Of course, my reference guide me here, and I will, as always, I will pay much attention to these grapsimata. Now, after I paint these grapsimata, I will create a first light. I will take some of the proplasmo of the inner part of the wings, and I will add a little bit of white and maybe a little bit of green if I want to make it greener or not. I will add maybe some blue. So titanium white and some blue or some green, and with this light color that you see me now painting with, I will paint some shapes like these to give the impression that I'm painting these feathers. Of course, these are very stylized. These are not naturalistic feathers. That's why the shapes are very geometric. I don't know how to call this shape. It's like an oval like shape. Anyway, this is something that the reference will guide you, but I've noticed that in many cases we can't actually understand what's going on in this inner part. So make sure that you paint the general feeling of the inner part of the wings that you see. I try to understand how the master iconographer uses the light in these inner parts, how light he goes, and which part he leaves it completely untouched, just with the proplasma. I would say this is a little bit one of the confusing, I would say, areas in iconography. Don't worry if you don't fully grasp what's going on. Just try to not overdo it and keep this beautiful, though inner part of the wings very discreet, better more discreet than more garish. So then make a second brighter light, and with this just highlight these feathers according to the reference that you use. You don't need too much highlights there. Try to again try to understand and see how the master has painted these feathers. This second light is not fully white. It is definitely lighter than the first light, but not pure titanium white. This inner part of the wings is a great chance to paint something beautiful in our icon. If we pay a lot of attention to this part, then this gives a lot of beauty to our icon. It's a great chance to really improve the way our icon looks. So give it much attention. Try to paint this inner part in a nice, beautiful way, and you will really be rewarded. I've seen some Western icons, mostly of the late medieval period, early Renaissance, where this inner part of the wings is just absolutely fantastic. It's like a rainbow of colors and truly, truly beautiful. Then you can go even lighter a little bit, create these little highlights. Now, these highlights have to be somehow organic to obey into some law of lighting inner wing parts. Of course, that doesn't exist, but just make sure that you understand where you place these highlights and try to be discreet and not really overdo it. We usually apply these stronger lights on the upper parts of the inner part of the wings. Sometimes you need to make something stronger in order for the rest to make sense. So after bringing this inner part in a state that feels good, acceptable, then we proceed with painting the grapsimata, the shadowy parts of the outer part of the wings. Now, these grapsimata are of course very important, as you will see. and really you should pay much attention to them. I create these grapsimata with I use some of the proplasmon of these wings. I will take some yellow ochre, some cadmium yellow, and a little bit of black, and I will add some more black, maybe a little bit of iron oxide red, and create this brown color. You don't have to go very dark from the beginning. Just make sure that is dark enough, and just draw the basic, let's say, contours of the wing. Just a line around these the outer wings, and then see if you can do some blending. With a more thin, more diluted with egg solution liquid, and as you will see in this video. But before doing any blending between this grapsimata and their proplasmon, just draw with your little brush the some basic feathers on the wings. I have to say that painting wings is something very satisfying for some reason. I really don't know why, but it's really satisfying. They are very impressive. And of course, if you gild them and apply gold leaf on them, then they truly are wonderful. But even if you just pay, you just highlight them with color, they are still very, very impressive. At this point, I will say that if I had to gild these wings, so far I would follow exactly the same process, proplasmo, grapsimata, everything, exactly the same process. I would just make there would just be one difference. When I was to paint my proplasmo, if I was thinking to gild the wing with gold, I would prepare a proplasmo that its consistency was much less of egg solution. Like the percentage of egg yolk would be less. I want to create a proplasmo that is less oily, less yolky, let's say, so that it will not I will not run the risk to glue my gold leaf on the fatty proplasmon. So I would create a proplasmon on my palette with more water than yolk. So I hope this is not confusing to you. If you have some experience, you will understand what I'm talking about. And if you find this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to this channel. It's really rewarding to me and gives me the motivation to continue uploading these videos. Of course, I have my patrons, the people who support me further on patreon.com. It's really amazing that these people decide to support me, and thank you so much for this. I upload on patreon.com some exclusive content for the people who show their appreciation there. And if you feel like it would be amazing and much needed to have your support on patreon.com. The link will be below. Of course, if you feel like having me mentor you online, feel free to contact me on my email address and ask me for ask me the details of these lessons I give online to one to one. So here, as you see, I've started doing my blending. I will take that same grapsimo and I will add some thin color, some thin egg solution to thin it down. And I will also add a little bit of the color of Plasmos to lighten it just a tiny little bit. And then with the tip of my brush, I will just paint these shadows on the edge of these feathers, as we call them, these Byzantine feathers, and on the edge of the wing, around the edge of the wing. This blending, this shadowing here directly gives some volume, adds some volume to this wing and makes it much more interesting visually. Now, I just try to be very consistent with my reference, and the reference guide me. If you don't have a reference, you have to understand that these feathers are almost scattered on the wing. But as you notice, we don't paint these feathers on the upper part of the wing, as there will be more light gathered, more highlights, and we don't need any of these shadowy parts on the top of the wing. Here you see me doing some further blending with an in-between tone. I add some more of the lighter color of Proplasmo to my grapsimata, and with this I will just go around and sweeten a little bit the transition between this shadowy part of the feathers to the Proplasmo. I take my time, since this is part of the grapsimata, of the process of the grapsimata, and as I always say, the process of grapsimata, whatever you paint, is really, really important. And then, if I feel like, I can do some more sharp, more evident, this shadowing of the feathers on their lowest part, just to give them a little bit more of this illusion of volume. Some master iconographers really go as dark, some others not. In this case, I will I darken these feathers, but also I will make sure that there is some blending as well, as you see here. The secret here is to keep your color thin enough, but not, of course, extremely thin. Thin enough, paint on the tip of your brush, and you will see how easy it is to make these transitions smoother and sweeter. See how long it takes me to finish this γραψίματα step. I'm not in a hurry to proceed with, to the most impressive highlights. I take my time and create the γραψίματα as best as it needs to be. Then I will take a brush that is long-haired, as you see here. It's the same brand that I normally use, but this is a long-haired, and I have to say that I'm not much accustomed to using long-hair brushes, but it really felt that here I had to use long hair, and it did make a difference. So, in order to make these highlights, I prepare a color here that consists from titanium white and cadmium yellow, just these colors. Titanium white will give the color its opacity, its strength that you see, and cadmium yellow will give its yellow, this yellow color that, in combination to the whiteness of titanium, we will have a color that really looks much like gold. So, with this color that is very strong, I would say, very opaque, and we need it to be very opaque, we will paint these highlights, these, let's say, explosions of gold reflections on the wings. So, try to familiarize yourselves with this long-haired brush. It's really important. It's of course a Kolinsky brush, and try to familiarize yourselves with that, and you'll see how nice you will paint these lines. Here, of course, my guide is my reference, and I try to, even if I don't copy exactly what I'm seeing, I'm trying to copy the general feeling these lights give me. Try to understand also it's their logic, how the master iconographer lights this. I see that he uses these lights around the feathers, and then he makes this round light around the feather, and then three little lines going down, running down from this feather. So I try to imitate this, and of course I keep my lines thin on their start, on their beginning, and thin on their end. This also takes some time. It is, I would say that this process is both a little bit tedious, tiring, because it requires some precision. But I have to say that it really is very, very satisfying, just because the effect, the result of these lights is so dramatic, it's so beautiful, and it just transforms the wing of to all its beauty. So I just can't wait to see this wing finished. Of course, when I'm in this state of enthusiasm about what I'm painting, I am also in a hurry to see this finished, and this works against the quality of my painting. So I have to remember to be patient, to just continue this beautiful process as best I can, and I will enjoy the result pretty soon. I shouldn't be in a hurry. The Kolinsky brush really cooperates very well. And I'm very happy because even though I'm not much or as much familiar to it as I would like, I really feel that this could work wonders for me if I become more familiar and I practice more with painting with this long haired brush. See how nice this wing appears. And as I tell, you don't need to be perfectly to copy perfectly the master iconographer. Just try to understand its the patterns, the way he uses to light the wing, and you will be fine. And now here comes my favorite part of lighting the wing, this upper part. Make sure that the consistency of your color is good. There is some flow on your color, and your brush works nice. That is thin enough to flow from your brush and thick enough to cover really everything with one layer. So here I will make this highlight that is very sharp and consists from these beautifully long lines. As I say, we are not robots and we are not expected to always paint perfectly. So it's okay if our lines are a little bit not, as decisive as they could be. Try your best, and you can also try to practice a little bit on a piece of paper before these lines. It's good to practice. And I'm pretty sure that the result. If you spend some time and you're not in a hurry, the result will be fine. Sometimes I've seen these lines being a little bit shaky or reluctant a little bit, and the result is really great. I would like to tell you that I have some news for you, and it's exciting for me that my course on iconography is on. I will have the description below, and currently on this week it's going to be only in English. The course is about iconography and how to paint an icon from scratch, like from drawing the basic facial characteristics to varnishing the icon. Is like the complete process in a bunch of videos that they altogether they are 9 hours and more long. It's like 25 videos in one course. And it's very exciting to me because this course will be also in Greek language. Many of my viewers asked me to do these courses, these tutorials in Greek. And to me, it's very important to reach an audience all over everywhere in the world, and especially to the people who don't have access to proper mentoring in iconography. Where they live. So, in this course, on this week it will be available only in English, but next week it's going to be available in Greek as well. And this is very, very exciting news to me. So, if you are interested in this course, check it on the description below and see if it suits your needs. So I will Almost, I finished painting this wing. I think it looks nice. It looks wingy, and I hope you understood this process and it was thoroughly explained to you. So, a big thank you for being here, being part of this community. Your comments on the section below are just amazing. They are so heartwarming, and thank you so much for these comments. Please like this video if you want, and I want to tell you to just stay healthy and creative. I will see you soon with another video tutorial. Bye.